Hello, and welcome to the AYTM.com competitive topography tutorial video. This video will show you how to leverage sophisticated research methodologies to get deep insights into your competitive landscape. You will learn the basics of the methodology, how to set up and launch the test, and how to interpret the data. The purpose of this turnkey solution is to explore a number of entities, such as brands, competing in the same market. Exploration is done by asking respondents to rate each brand by a number of attributes. For example, to get an idea of the fast food industry in the US, you may want to rate McDonald's, Wendy's, Burger King, and others in their competitive set on attributes like food quality, price, healthiness, speed of service, etc. This methodology will give you an important understanding of consumers' perceptions of each brand, perceived similarities between them, each brand's most differentiating attributes, and a visual comparison of ratings among the restaurants in aggregate, as well as individually by each attribute. To accomplish this deep analysis, researchers used to run complicated, expensive, and time-consuming data modeling projects. At times, these projects needed to be rerun if some of the parameters changed during the experiment. One of my favorite things about our version of this test is that it's incredibly easy to set up. The competitive topography research test can be added just like you would add any of our other question types. You can simply drag and drop from the sidebar, or add it at the bottom of the survey. You can also convert an existing question into a competitive topography question. All you have to do now is to fill out the list of brands you want to test and the list of attributes. If you're not sure which items to add, or you have a very long list, it may be wise to first run a max diff survey to narrow down a longer list of attributes to just 5 to 7 of the most important ones. Alternatively, you can ask an unaided open-ended question and code the answers, arriving at the list of the most frequently referenced brands and attributes. If you already know what you want to test, you can proceed without this extra step. The model works best with at least 4 entities and 4 attributes, and you can add up to 10 items in each list. Please note that we recommend having about 7 items in each list in order to get the most informative visualizations. Reach out to us if you need to add more into the test. Add more by clicking here, or remove extras by Xing them out. In the right bottom corner of the attributes list, you will find a combo box with a preset library of common attributes broken out into 3 groups: product attributes, service attributes, and general brand attributes. As with most other question types, you have the ability to illustrate every field, add logos as I did here, and randomize the order in which they will be presented. If you don't want certain options to be randomized, you can easily anchor them in place so they appear in the same order for each respondent. Now it's time to decide whether you want respondents to rate each brand with stars, which is the default mode on our platform, or sliders. If you choose to use a star rating, you'll be able to use 5, 7, or 9 stars for each attribute. Choosing sliders will give you more flexibility. You'll be able to choose from our library of pre-written Likert scales, edit the answers, write your own custom answers, and even adjust the scores from 1 to 99, which are provided automatically for you when an answer is chosen. By default, we assume 10 points for 1 star, or the lowest answer on your Likert scale, and we go all the way up to 50, 70, or 90 for a top rating. If you decide to edit the Likert scale or adjust the scoring, please make sure you know exactly what you're doing, since it may drastically affect your model and data visualization. The last important decision here is to choose how to group these 2 lists. By default, we'll group them by entities, or brands in this case. That means that each brand will be presented as a separate question, with attributes listed as sub-questions below. This grouping may be easier on respondents, since it helps them to activate memories of all their experiences with a given brand or entity, enabling respondents to rate each brand or entity by all attributes you're testing. If you switch to group by attribute, each question will ask about 1 attribute at a time, such as food healthiness, and will contain all compared brands on the page. It might introduce a higher cognitive toll on respondents, since they'll have to access a lot more memories across brands in order to answer each of the questions. Even so, in some cases, this might be more valuable, since it'll help focus attention on comparing all brands across a given attribute. Please note that this experiment will take as many questions as there are items in the list you're presenting. In my example, we see 8. Now it's time to make sure the question is still appropriate for your case. We have four pre-written question texts designed for star ratings and sliders in both modes, grouped by entities and by attributes. Our platform will suggest default text as you adjust the parameters of the experiment, as long as the field is empty or untouched. If you edited the field already, we won't mess with your text, but you'll have to understand how it works and carefully test it out. You may notice the internal piping here. If you group by entities, the word entity will be replaced by a brand as you roll over it, helping you preview how each of the questions will read in the survey. The same thing will happen with your attributes. If you accidentally remove the magic word in square brackets, don't panic. You can type it back in, or click on the warning that will appear underneath. You can click on the question icon to read a quick blurb about how it works. Clicking on the text of the warning will insert the code at the end of your question. Make sure you move it to the appropriate part of your sentence. You can combine the competitive topography test with any other questions in your survey. As with any other survey, please test your entire survey carefully in preview mode and launch it as you would any other survey on our platform. To get the most reliable insights, we recommend that you run this research model with 750 to 1500 completes. Let's now look at the results and explore how to interact with your data visualizations and interpret your data. There are three distinct ways you can visualize the results: multidimensional scale, topography view, and quadrant analysis. You can toggle among them at the top of this test. The multidimensional scale is closest to classic perceptual mapping visualization. I won't torture you with the technical details, but essentially the rendering treats each of the attributes you added as a separate dimension or axis in a hard-to-imagine multidimensional space. It looks for a balance among all the forces and puts your tested entities into very specific positions in relation to each other within this space. Then our rendering runs up to 200 attempts to find the most accurate two-dimensional version it can create of this multidimensional model to make it comprehensible for those of us mere mortals who can only perceive images in three dimensions. We list the R-square, or projection accuracy, in percents. It usually varies from 95 to 100%. Let's take a closer look at the visualization. The first thing you'll notice is that the brands are depicted with color dots and have horizontal labels. Attributes are shown as axes, meeting in the center and labeled along each line. Some attributes might be so close to each other in the minds of survey takers that we'll have to blend them into a single line and list both labels one after another, like I have here for food quality taste and cleanliness appearance. In such cases, the labels will go in the same order as the blue dots on the axis. Please note that some axes depicting attributes are in bold. These were the most differentiated attributes according to respondents. We can't automatically assume that these are the most important to the industry or consumers. Let's just say that these had the most variation from brand to brand, and therefore we're very confident that if a brand performs well or poorly on a bold-faced trait, it stands out considerably from the others in respondents' minds. Next, you may notice that some axes are shorter than others. Each of them ends with a blue dot, which we call the epicenter of an attribute. If an attribute is short and close to the center, it means this attribute was similar among all your tested brands and wasn't associated strongly with any particular one. When analyzing this visualization, please pay close attention to the proximity of the brands and attributes' epicenters, not the axes. For example, Taco Bell is equally close to both the convenience location and price axes, but it's much closer to the epicenter of the prices attribute, which is what matters. We can interpret it as that Taco Bell was closely associated with good pricing. We can also conclude that in consumers' perceptions, both Burger King and Taco Bell were seen as similar to each other, with strong associations of affordability, variety, speed, and convenience of locations. They were not specifically associated with food quality taste or food healthiness, which are on the opposite side of the map. Subway, on the other hand, was different from all the other brands tested here. We can see that it came closest to the epicenter of food healthiness, which was one of the strongest differentiating attributes in our study. Arby's and Chick-fil-A were most closely affiliated with taste and cleanliness, and McDonald's with convenience of location and prices. In fact, you can read the most associated attributes for each brand from the table below. We'll list them in descending order, with the average score each brand received for the corresponding attribute. Speaking of scores, proximity of a brand to an attribute's epicenter can't always tell the full story about what forces resulted in a brand hovering at a given place on the competitive map. In order to find out how strongly each brand has performed, simply click on the corresponding dot or brand label. If you click on Subway, for instance, you'll notice colored beams appear from the center. The length of the beam represents the average score that the brand reached for that particular attribute. In order for a beam to reach the blue dot, which marks an attribute's epicenter, all respondents would have had to have given the maximum possible rating for it. In reality, that almost never happens, but it helps you to judge how close a brand was able to come to dominating an attribute. By using this visualization, Subway was very highly rated on both food healthiness and convenience of location. The reason why it's not closer to the center of the map is that food healthiness was a stronger force, and there's enough pull from a few other axes to keep the brand in the top right corner. Next thing that you'll notice is the color. Subway was rated higher than other brands by most of the attributes, which is why we presented in green. Please refer to the legend for the relative breakdown. If you click on McDonald's, you'll see a very different picture. While it was in the top percentiles for convenience, location, and prices, it was rated lower compared to other brands in food healthiness and taste. You can explore all the brands we tested and export each view mode as an image in PNG, EPS, or PDF format by clicking this icon. Let's now switch to the topography view mode. This is something we invented here at AYTM. It's based on the same multidimensional scale model I just showed you, but presented in an interactive, intuitive 3D model. By adding a third dimension, we enable you to visualize the scores as the heights of a landscape, while keeping the proximities intact between brands and attributes. As you may have guessed, the entities or brands are presented with color pins and horizontal labels, while the epicenters of attributes are marked with white flags and labeled vertically. You can rotate the model and explore it from any angle. You can zoom in or out by using the scroll wheel of your mouse or scroll gesture on a trackpad. The color helps highlight different heights to better represent mean scores, and you can refer to the legend on the bottom for the exact range of values. The higher the mountain and closer to the red side of the spectrum, the higher the mean score an entity has received. The deeper the valley and the closer to dark blue it is, the lower the mean score. From this summary view, we can easily assess that Subway was far ahead of the other brands by total score, since it resides on the top of a high mountain while the rest are on the foothills or in the valley. You may also see that the closest attribute to the Subway mountain was again food healthiness, while McDonald's was very close to the epicenter of the convenience location attribute. Now that we know how to use and interpret the visualization, let's take a look at the different ways we can explore it. You can look at your insights from the perspective of either brands or attributes, and it doesn't matter how you grouped your lists during survey collection. Entities or brands is the default setting. The combo box on the right allows you to control what variable we will visualize using the height of the terrain. Switching from the total mean scores to any of the individual brands will show a different picture every time. For example, here's the terrain for McDonald's. It has a peak of convenience of location, indicating that this was perceived as McDonald's strongest trait, and a valley of food healthiness, indicating that this was perceived as McDonald's weakest trait. All the other qualities are arranged on different heights in between. Please note that in the table below, you'll see mean scores for each of the brand's attributes. Now if we switch to Subway, we have a very different picture. Most of the attributes of this chain were rated very highly except for prices, which formed a small but deep valley in the center. You can continue exploring brand by brand, or toggle to attributes mode. The default view here shows me the summary of all mean scores given to all brands by different attributes. You can learn something additional here, that most attributes were rated approximately the same, with a couple of small orange hills around cleanliness, taste, speed, and convenience, while food healthiness, surprise surprise, was rated drastically lower for these fast food brands. As before, you can select any individual attribute from the list on the right, and see which brand dominated that attribute. We already learned that food healthiness is strongly associated with Subway, followed by Chick-fil-A and Wendy's. When we check out prices, on the other hand, we can see which brands are perceived as most and least affordable. Even though Subway has a lower rating for prices in comparison to its ratings on other attributes, when compared to the other brands we tested, its prices are still rated very well. Check the exact scores in the table below to get precise readings. Two combo boxes below allow you to declutter the visualization, which is especially useful for the summary view modes when too many elements are competing for your attention. Hiding an entity or attribute label will not alter the underlying model. It'll simply remove the element from the screen so that you can export exactly what you need to illustrate and communicate the finding in your presentation. You can export any view as an image, or as a vector graphic, which can be scaled to any size without compromising the quality. Please note that when you export the survey into PowerPoint, only the current 3D view will be included. If you'd like to show more than one view, you'll need to manually export each image and paste it into your presentation. Before we move on to the last view mode, I want to share a cool little Easter egg with you. If you left-click on the 3D visualization while holding your Shift key, the terrain will start slowly rotating. During this presentation mode, you can still interact with it, change the tilt, zoom in and out, etc. To stop, Shift and left-click again. If you're using a Mac, try holding down the Shift and Command keys when you click to get the same effect. Last but not least, Quadrant View. By the way, if all you need is this view, you can save a lot of money by ordering the Quadrant Analysis question type instead of the Competitive Topography. This view is much simpler to understand and has no underlying statistical analysis whatsoever. It allows you to assign any of the attributes to each of the axes, and the entities will be positioned accordingly on the grid. You can also use size and color to visualize two more attributes. For example, if I set convenience location as the x-axis, and food healthiness as the y-axis, food quality taste as size, and food menu options variety as color, I'll get this picture. It helps me quickly identify the leaders by all four attributes. It wouldn't be fun if we hadn't added an extra twist to this view mode on top of what you'd normally expect from a quadrant analysis. When you click on a circle, you can see the actual distribution of answer combinations by the current X and Y attributes. Why does it matter? Since the position of the brands is a mean of all collected ratings, sometimes it's unclear what distribution of answers resulted in such a mean. For example, respondents could have been very polarized in their ratings, or they all consistently gave an average rating. In both cases, the mean score and the location of the brand would be very similar, and you wouldn't know the underlying truth. To discover the exact number of people who gave a certain combination of ratings, hover over the gray dots on the grid. The circle in the left bottom corner, for example, represents 1 star for convenience and 1 star for food healthiness, and 36 people gave that combination of ratings. The largest gray circle seems to be in the center of the right-hand column, and this is because it was the most popular combination. 148 people gave the chain 7 stars for convenience and 4 for healthiness. Another useful thing about Quadrant View is that you can see mean ratings for up to 4 selected attributes at a time in the grid below. Click on the headers to sort in ascending or descending order. Probably the most amazing thing about competitive topography and other research tests that you can run on the AYTM platform, besides being great interactive visualizations and easy to use, is that they're fully integrated into the stats page. This means that you can apply any combination of filters by demographics and/or traits and have the numbers recrunched in almost real time for you. You can see, for example, how perception of these fast food restaurants varied between genders or among age groups. You could even select a subset of respondents, such as those who are most loyal to Chick-fil-A, and view their overall perspective on our competitive set of quick service restaurants. This concludes the competitive topography tutorial. I encourage you to play with the demo survey available on our site and read more about this research test in the question type section. Thanks again for watching, and feel free to ping us with questions or to set up a personal demo.